YouTube, hey guys, come on. Hey YouTube pipe community, here at the Chicago Pipe Show 2018. Just underway, first day.
It's first day. Busy.
Want to introduce yourself to the two people watching?
I'm Pierre Jensen, I'm from McBaren, product specialist and tobacco developer.
That's it?
All right. Yeah. We have a tradition when Pierre shows up, because he didn't show up last year.
Out of fear. Yes.
We have a tradition that Pear opens up a vintage tin on camera with us.
Yep.
Pear does not know what I have behind my back, and he's finding out now.
Wow.
Symphony.
Wow.
I'm trying.
And we are going way, 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 way back.
All right. Way, 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 way. Oh, let's talk about it before we try to open it.
Well. This is Faber & Co., our distributor. That was before Fireside. Fireside was in the 70s, so this is probably 60s.
60s?
Yes. Late 60s. Ready to rub along the tour? Yeah. Whoa.
Okay, so I want to...
If I give you $15.49, is that mine?
Well, we're at the Chicago Pipe Show, $20 special.
Oh, okay. Well, that's too expensive.
All right, so 2 years ago, three years ago, we talked about rusted tins.
Yeah.
People complain that the tins got rust in there.
Yep.
You explained to us why that happens.
Yep.
And you explained to us that it has no effect on the tobacco.
No effect whatsoever.
I just want to say, looking at this tin makes way more sense.
Yeah.
All right. Can you talk about that?
Well, this tin was used, at that time, metal was the only thing you could actually use to put tobacco in. That was before the cardboard tubes were made where we could fill in tobacco as we do today.
Okay.
So metal was the only thing running. So we had to do it.
Is there a problem with storing things in these tins?
No. It was, the rust came from the vinegar that we are using in some of the blends. This has no vinegar.
No vinegar.
So it's not, the metal is not attacked. And now I hope when I open it, I'm right.
And then a couple more questions. What is Symphony?
Symphony is, Symphony is an American name. Because in Europe we call it Harmony. But it's still the same tobaccos. It's a Burley dominated tobacco. It has 60% Burley, 40% Virginia.
Dark fire?
Nope, no dark fire.
Okay.
Normal Burley.
All right.
Yeah. So it's one of our oldest blends, coming from, let's say, late 40s.
Okay.
Came after the mixture, but just shortly after.
Is it still in production?
It's still in production.
Okay.
So you can actually buy a 100-gram tin today with... Symphony.
Go to your local tobacconist and order Symphony today.
So, how much longer should I stand with the tin without opening it?
There you go.
Oh. Ah, yeah. You see, even the plastic
is yellow.
It's yellow, but doing okay. So, now I could use raw force, or if you have something to cut or. Yeah.
Okay.
Good joy. Good destroy.
We didn't get the tin pop this year.
Nah. So. Beautiful inlay.
A very harmonious smoking tobacco. Ready rub tobacco of Kentucky, Burley, Virginia, and Cavendish. All specially palatable tobacco with a light, sweet taste and cool to smoke.
And for that price, you've got two of them.
Oh.
Well, it's dry.
Mm-hmm.
Because the plastic, the barrier properties of the plastic is not the same as metal. So it evaporates, the water evaporates. This should make a little bit of an explosion. When you fill the pipe, you light it.
Yeah.
It goes on.
But it still has a good smell.
Ah, it's a fantastic smell. Yeah. No, that's good.
Yeah, that's good.
You see, it's even so dry, I won't steal any of this.
You can steal it if you want.
Yeah.
You have your ways.
Yeah, yeah. You see, I have the whole tin before you leave.
Well, it's easy enough to
do. So if we should compare it to something?
Is it darker? Or is that about the color it was?
More or less the color it was.
More or less, yeah. All right.
Because that's probably dried out within 1 year. And then nothing happens. Then it stays in color, it doesn't age, it doesn't do anything.
All right.
To do that, you need a tin with the vacuum.
Yeah.
Like these ones. You see, if you check the lid, where do we have the lid? It's on the bottom. It has a rubber band. So the tin seals, but the plastic here, water just evaporates. And they were never good at holding the vacuum.
Okay.
So at some time, air came in and water disappeared.
All right.
I'm sorry, but...
That's actually why I brought this tin. I wanted you to explain why these are superior for the aging process.
What we are doing today, that is, again, we have here the tobacco. I can lift it up a little bit. Like this. And here we can actually make a really vacuum. Take 40% of the air out. The upper tin here is sucked through the rubber, and it will last for 30, 40, 50 years.
Yeah.
And it will age because humidity stays in the tin. So that is a much wiser, the best tins we actually have is the round tins.
Yeah.
These have a little bit problem where they can, well, they don't fit that good.
Yeah.
Like a round, because it's glued on and then we remove the air. This we just put on and remove the air. So this might lighter lose the vacuum. So round tins are always the best to store tobacco.
Is there ever a plan to put everything in a round tin? I see other companies doing that.
Yeah, but that is because the supplier.
Okay.
There's no more supplying the square tins. We bought enough stock for the next 2 years.
All right.
And then we have 2 years where we can think, what are we going to do next? It could be you'll find McBaron Flake in round tins. Very probable.
Just because a tin changes doesn't mean the tobacco changed.
Yep.
People say that all the time.
That is the headline. Yeah. Actually, yeah. So, got more?
You got this.
Okay.
Is there anything else you want to say about the new Burley Flake or about your tin product?
If you are a Burley smoker, my suggestion is to try the HH Burley Flake. It's a fantastic Burley. It's a very deep, nutty, chocolate note. The most important in this blend is we are using one Burley out of Far East. And Far East is not the place where you would say, this is where my Burley come from. But Indonesia have some fantastic Burleys. And one of them gives this blend personality. I cannot use the word sweet in Burley.
Okay.
But I almost will, because it adds a funny sweetness to it. There's only a dash of dark fried Kentucky in it, not to give taste, but to boost, to give a little bit more satisfaction. We've got 65% Burley, the rest is 5% dark fired, and the rest is Virginia.
All right.
Smooth, smoky.
How long did that take you? How many run-throughs did you have?
Well, I've been working on this for the last 1.5 years.
All right.
So we are in the third generation. So I mean, three times we have changed the water baggers before we get to time. That is
awesome.
Okay. Thank you very much.
See you guys.